Hello friends, welcome to UPSC Logics and my name is Siddharth and today I am going to discuss about the Swarajists. These were the people who formed the Swaraj Party and were also known as pro-changers. So they formed the Swaraj Party in 1923 and in this video we shall have a look at the origin and the objectives of this particular party. Then we shall have a look at the relationship with the Congress, the activities of this party and the decline of this party. So let us begin this video. So the origin of this party can be traced back to the Gaya session of Congress in 1922. Now we know that the non-cooperation movement had just been ended and Gandhiji had called off the non-cooperation movement because of the Chaura Chauri incident on 5th of February 1922. So C.R. Das, Motilal Nehru, Hakim Ajmal Khan, Ali Brothers and they declared that non-cooperation movement was a failure. In fact, Motilal Nehru had actually written a letter to Gandhiji asking him that why he had to suspend the non-cooperation movement for a single incident that happened in a remote part of India. So these particular members of Congress suggested an alternative program where they would join the legislative councils that had been established under the Montfort reforms of 1919 and they were going to be a part of the government and create a moral pressure to compel the British government to give in to the demand of self-government for India. So a large section of the Congress under C. Rajgopalachari opposed any diversion from Gandhiji's known objectives and programs. So these were the people who were known as the no-changers, while the people who suggested this particular change were known as the pro-changers. So on January 1, 1923, C.R. Das along with Motilal Nehru announced the formation of a new party that was known as the Swaraj Party. Now the Swaraj Party was not exactly a new party but was a party within the Congress. So the aims and objectives of this party were identical to those of the Congress, which was the achievement of self-government for India. Now the methods that were employed by this party were different, which was to be a part of the legislative councils and compel the British government to give in to India's demand of self-government, and they had certain objectives as well while they were a part of the legislative council. So number one was that they wanted to prevent any regressive legislatives that came out from the British government and were detrimental to the country's progress towards the attainment of self-government. Number two was that they wanted a constitution or a constitution to be framed or adopted that would be suitable to the country's needs. And number three was that if the government was uncooperative in these particular objectives or not letting the Congress or the Swaraj Party achieve these objectives, they would obstruct the normal functioning through the council. So this is how they actually intended to achieve the goal of self-government for India. So I hope you have understood this particular point as well, or the objectives of the Swaraj Party. Now we know that the no-changers were a strong section of the Congress. So they were not really in favor of a new party within the Congress. And as early as in February 1923, Maulana Abul Kalam Azad tried to narrow down the differences between the two factions of the Congress. But by May 1923, the Congress Working Committee endorsed the Swaraj Party's demand to contest the elections. And by 1925, Gandhiji had also given up on the Swaraj Party and accepted that Swaraj Party was the political wing of the Congress. However, the Swaraj Party lost the elections in 1926 and ultimately they were a part of the Congress in 1930. So Gandhiji's acceptance does not mean much in this relation, but that was the relationship with the Congress. Now the Swaraj Party, with the blessings of the Congress no changers, decided to fight the elections in November 1923. And they were pretty successful in fighting these elections as they were able to rout the moderates as well as the liberals. And they gained absolute majority in the central provinces, while in Bengal, United Provinces, Bombay and Assam, their gains were sizable. So almost 48 members of the Swaraj Party were able to return to the Central Legislative Assembly, where they joined with the independents under Muhammad Ali Jinnah and formed the Nationalist Party. So we know that finally the Swarajists were able to join the Central Legislative Assembly and they were in power, and they were joined by the independents under Muhammad Ali Jinnah to form the Nationalist Party. Now they started voicing their grievances and demanded for the release of political prisoners and Indianization of the civil as well as the defense services. They also attacked the government policies and exposed the various acts of omission and commission that were going on behind the scenes. And in the Central Legislative Assembly, they rejected the finance bill in 1924. So the government, to pacify the nationalists, they set up the Mudiman Committee to inquire into the working of the reforms of 1919. So Mudiman Committee was nothing but to examine the working of Dairaki of the Montague-Chelmsford reforms. So we shall have a look at the Mudiman Committee in a separate video. So in 1925, C.R. Das expired, and this led to a vacuum of leadership among the Swarajists. So differences started to arise between the Swarajists, and in the elections of 1926, the party lost pretty badly. So they fared pretty badly in Punjab and United Provinces. In fact, in Madras, Bengal and Assam, they fared no better. So in 1930, they boycotted the elections and returned to the parental fold of the Congress. So this was the end of Swaraj Party that was formed in 1923 by C.R. Das and Motilal Nehru. And although they had great aims and objectives, but they were unable to do so because of the differences that started to appear among the Swarajists themselves. Because C.R. Das expired, there was a vacuum that was created at the top of the party. So there was no one to bind the Swarajists together, and they started to blame each other, and ultimately they lost in the elections of 1926, and by 1930 they went back into the parental fold of the Congress. So friends, this brings us to the end of this particular video on the Swarajist, and I hope you have understood what the Swaraj Party was, what their objectives were, how they rose and how they declined, and how they were able to actually force the government to look into the working of Dairaki of the Montfort-Chelmsford reforms. And in the next video, we shall have a look at the Mudiman Committee that was formed because of the Swarajists. And this committee came in 1924 after the rejection of the finance bill in the Legislative Assembly. So thank you so much for watching this video, and do like and subscribe to the channel if you have enjoyed this video. And don't forget to press the bell icon to get the latest notifications from UPSC Logix. Thank you so much, and Jai Hind.